I'm Stephen Garcia.
I'm Ryan Hayden.
I'm McGrath.
We're doing Foot Locker Inc.
So Foot Locker Inc. is a multinational athletic shoe retailer and apparel retailer with over 3,300 stores across the US, Canada, Europe, and Asia. It was originally founded in 1988 under the name of the F.W. Woolworth Company, and it's headquartered in New York City, New York. And Foot Locker is a store that's primarily located in enclosed malls, and the company owns multiple brands, including Foot Locker, Kids Foot Locker, Lady Foot Locker, Foot Action, 602, Runners Point, Sidestep, Champ Sports, and East Bay. And a lot of those brands are brands that exist in other countries. And it was ranked number 348 on the 2017 Fortune 500 companies list, and it kind of has been steadily increasing in rank year to year.
As you can see from the graph, Foot Locker sales have been increasing rather steadily over the past several years. From 2015 to 2016, the sales increased about 4.5%, from 7.4 billion to 7.76 billion. And from 2016 to 2017, you can see how the net sales increase was rather stagnant. So sort of over these past several years, Foot Locker's closed over 150 physical locations. And so as you can see from 2016 to 2017, that 1% increase from about 7.76 billion to 7.78 billion, sort of a result of Foot Locker slimming down on their physical locations. But at the same time, I think it's sort of a testament to the company to show how even in times where they're struggling to adapt to new e-commerce markets and a variety of problems many physical store locations are facing these days, that they're able to keep their sales up. And as you can see, compared to their competitors, Foot Locker and Dick's have very similar numbers, but the stores are very similar sales, but the stores are almost completely different. When you think of a Dick's, you think of like a very large physical like department store that sells a variety of goods, whereas Foot Locker, a majority of things that come to mind would be like located in a mall. That's where most of the locations are, and mostly footwear is what they sell, whereas Dick's sells everything from basketball hoops to shoes to soccer balls. And so that's why I think a more interesting comparison is the Finish Line. They're also located in malls and have a online presence, but as you can see, their sales are dwarfed by Foot Locker's.
All right, getting to liquidity, solvency, and profitability. We use earnings per share to calculate profitability. And as you can see, over the past few years, 2016 was a great year for Foot Locker. They rose from $3.84 per share to $4.91. And then in 2017, they took a big hit, partly because they had some legal issues with a pension class action lawsuit, and that took a lot of money. And yeah, so their profitability went down a lot because of that. For solvency, we used our debt-to-assets ratio, and pretty much a similar trend. 2016 was the best year they did. They got rid of a lot of their debt, and again in 2017 they had to take out some loans, partly because of that litigation they had to deal with. And then for liquidity, we used the current ratio, and just as the other two, 2016 was their best year with 4.3 to 1, going down again in 2017. And then current events. So a big trend that's been going around is this mall crisis. A lot of malls, the mall traffic is decreasing and there's less people going to malls. There's been a few terrorist attacks in malls, kind of a downward trend. And the same goes for retail. Retail is a little bit in decline with the growth of e-commerce and all that. And another thing is people are buying basketball shoes less than they were in the past few years. There's been a big decline in that, and that really hurts. it's Foot Locker because such a big part of their sales is basketball shoes and stuff like that.
So, I'll tell it to you.
Since 2016, they had great sales. They produced more. And then in 2017, their sales declined. And so they're like unsure about the future because of that sale decline. And it's mainly because of this, what Stefan just said before, the mall crisis. They had like over 110 stores closed down throughout throughout malls in the United States. And retail is declining due to online companies like Amazon just taking over customers because customers don't want to go to the brick and mortar stores, which are like physical stores in malls. They'd rather just buy from their homes. Another reason is because consumers are becoming more conscious. Foot Locker's prices are generally higher than other stores like Dick's, for example, because Foot Locker's main product is shoes, and Dick's is generally multiple things. So Dick's shoes prices are like generally lower than Foot Locker's, and this leads to potential future losses for Foot Locker. And since their sales declined in 2017, that is shown through the information.
So we decided that you should not invest in Foot Locker Inc. because although the sales have remained relatively steady over recent years, given the decline in foot traffic in malls as a whole and the store closing across multiple of Foot Locker Inc.'s brands, they're already kind of facing tough obstacles, and they don't really seem like they're adapting extremely well, especially with e-commerce, because they're still kind of focused on their brick and mortar locations as opposed to like trying to compete with Nike.com and Amazon. Their stock prices has also been down significantly in the last year, and their earnings per share has been steadily decreasing over the last 3 years.